Hey guys, welcome back to One Stop Biology. So guys, in today's video we are going to understand what exactly water pollution is and what are the different pollutants and how we can exactly prevent water pollution or how we can lessen the effect that till now the pollutants have caused in water. So guys, again, if you are new to the channel and you have not subscribed to my channel yet, please do press the subscribe button and along with that, yes, the bell icon as well, so that you get all the notifications. And do give your feedback. You can give your feedback in the comments of the video. And if you understand all the videos, please do like the videos and share it with all your friends. So guys, if we start talking about the water pollution, basically, again, as we have abused the air that we discussed in the last video, right, that we have abused air in different ways, like automobiles and in different types of industries, right? In the same way, we human beings have been abusing the water bodies as well around the earth. And basically, we are disposing all different kind of wastes in the water itself. So basically, we always tend to believe that water can wash away everything, but we do not understand that water bodies are our lifeline. It is our lifeline, right? And it is lifeline for other living organisms as well. It is, you know, one of the most important habitats, the aquatic habitats, and so many different types of plants and animals are completely dependent on this kind of habitats, right? But due to some, you know, several different kind of activities of us, the ponds, lake, ocean, rivers, everything are becoming polluted in several parts of the world. So basically, realizing the importance of maintaining the cleanliness of water, again here the government of India passed Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act, and this was passed in 1974. So basically, this was passed to safeguard our water resources. Now let's understand some of the effluents. So the first one is domestic sewage and industrial effluents. Now guys, you see that industries plays a major role in, you know, different type of pollutants which are polluting air, water, soil, everything, right? So when we talk about these domestic sewage and industrial effluents, guys, you know, all the cities and towns, they have a drainage system, and these drainage systems are basically passed on in the local water bodies. So if there are ponds, if there are rivers, or if there is a sea nearby, right, everything that is there in the sewage system of that particular city or village or town, it is passed on to that water body. And what we say is that, you know, a mere 0.1% impurity make domestic sewage unfit for human use, right? So basically, if we see this chart here as well, you'll see that out of the entire water body, the composition of wastewater, if you see, impurities are just 0.1%. So these are basically what? These are suspended solids and sand, silt and clay. Then there are colloidal material like fecal matter, bacteria, cloth and paper fibers. And then there are some dissolved materials like nutrients, nitrate, ammonia, phosphate, sodium and calcium, right? So basically, now if we talk about the sewage treatment, so basically if the impurity is so less that it is unfit for human use, what we can do is basically we can treat this water and reuse it, right? So now if we talk about the treatment of sewage system, now the solid part, the solids which are present in the sewage are relatively easy to remove. What is the most difficult to remove is the dissolved material. Like, so basically the dissolved materials like nitrates, phosphates, and other nutrients. There are some toxic metals as well. Right, so domestic sewage primarily contains biodegradable organic matter, right, and this readily decomposes. Now, all thanks to the bacteria or other microorganisms, which basically can multiply using organic substances as substrates, and they utilize some of the components of sewage. Now, it is possible to estimate the amount of biodegradable organic matter in sewage water by measuring the biochemical oxygen in demand. Right? So, basically, if we talk about the biochemical oxygen in demand, we'll understand what it is exactly. It is known as BOD. Right? So, if you see this particular chart or this particular graph, you'll see that what is discharge of sewage into a river and basically what are the effect of sewage discharge on important characteristics of a river. Say this is the sewage discharge. Now, guys, this is the direction of flow. This is the concentration. Okay. This is the biological oxygen in demand, and this is the dissolved oxygen. So the red one that you see, this one is the dissolved oxygen, and this is the biological oxygen in demand. So basically, fish are killed and disappearance of clean water, and then again reappearance of clean water organisms, right? So basically, the microorganisms are involved in biodegradation of organic matter, which is present in the receiving water body, and it consumes a lot of oxygen, right? This biodegradation consumes a lot of oxygen, and that is why, as a result of this, there is a sharp decline in dissolved oxygen. Now, that is from downstream from the point of sewage discharge, right? Now, this causes mortality of fish and other aquatic creatures. Now, presence of large amount of nutrients in water also causes excessive growth of planktonic, like free floating algae, and this is known as algal bloom, guys. This is known as algal bloom, and this imparts a distinct color to the water body. And this algal bloom causes deterioration of water quality and then fish mortality. So again, you know, present of large amount of nutrients also causes problem. Right? Now, apart from that, right? So basically, not just fish, apart from that, these bloom forming algae are even toxic to human beings and other animals as well. Right? Again, apart from that, I am sure you would have seen, you know, mauve colored or pink colored flowers which are, you know, floating, which are present floating in the water bodies. These are basically floating plants in water bodies. So again, these plants were introduced into India for their lovely flowers, big lovely flowers. But then excessive growth of these plants cause what happens is it causes blocks in our waterways. So basically, they grow at a very faster rate, right? For example, water hyacinth. Now, water hyacinth is known as the world's most problematic aquatic plant. It is considered as an aquatic weed, and it happened in Bengal that they grew so much. They were so much in abundant in all the water bodies in West Bengal that they caused an abrupt imbalance in the ecosystem of that water body, and that is why they are also known as terror of Bengal, right? So basically, guys, the sewage from homes and the hospitals. Now, these are also likely to contain many undesirable pathogenic microorganisms. And disposal into a water without proper treatment can also cause serious diseases, outbreak of diseases like dysentery, typhoid, jaundice, cholera, and all that, right? Now, unlike domestic sewage, water from the industries, now these like industries like petroleum, chemical manufacturing, or paper manufacturing, or metal industry, or chemical manufacturing. So what happens there is they contain toxic substances, right? Like they have heavy metals, say mercury, cadmium, copper, lead, right? And they then also have a lot of organic compounds. Again, these toxic substances which are present in industrial wastewater can undergo biological magnification, which is known as biomagnification in the aquatic food chain. So basically, what is biomagnification? Guys, biomagnification refers to increase in concentration of toxicant at successive trophic levels. So we have understood the concept of different trophic levels, right? Now basically these intoxicants are passed on at different trophic levels with time, and it causes harm to all of these food chains, all of the organisms which are part of one food chain, or all the food chains which together form the food web, right? So basically this happens because the toxic substance is accumulated by an organism and it cannot be metabolized or excreted. So that is why it gets passed on to the next higher trophic level. And this phenomenon is well known for mercury and DDT, right? And I'll show you a figure as well. So basically, this is biomagnification of DDT in an aquatic food chain. What you can see here is that in water, the amount of DDT is 0.003, and this is parts per billion, right? Now, if you go to the above, so in zooplankton, it is 0.04 parts per million. Now, see, from billion, we reach to million. Then in small fishes, it is 0.5 parts per million. Now, when the small fishes are being eaten by the large fishes, it is becoming 2. From 0.5, it jumped to 2 parts per million. And then when the fish-eating birds capture these fishes, it is even reaching up to 25 parts per million. And this is the reason that, you know, the fish-eating birds are becoming extinct or are becoming endangered. So what happens is that high concentration of DDT disturbs the calcium metabolism in birds, and this causes thinning of eggshell and premature breaking of the eggshells. And because of this, there is a decline in bird population, right? Now, again, in similar way, there is another process which is eutrophication. Eutrophication is nothing but, you know, natural aging of a lake by nutrient enrichment of its water. So basically, in a young lake, the water is cold and clear, supporting little life. With time, streams draining into the lake introduces nutrients such as nitrogen and phosphorus. Now, this encourages growth of aquatic organisms. Now, because the lake's fertility increases, the plant and animal life increases, and organic remains begin to deposit on the lake bottom. Now, over the centuries, when the silt and organic debris, all of this pile up, the lake grows shallower and warmer, and with warm water organisms, basically there are lakes that grow, you know, start growing the marsh plants. And then, you know, ultimately what happens is that you will see lake which gives way to large masses of floating plants, and finally it gets converted into land, and we have studied this before as well. Now, depending on climate, size of the lake, and there are various factors because of which there is a natural aging of lake. Now, this may happen in thousands of years. But because of pollutants from man's activities, because of effluents from the industries or homes, the aging process of lakes are being accelerated. And this phenomenon is known as cultural or accelerated eutrophication. So, during the past century, guys, lakes in many parts have been severely eutrophied by sewage and agricultural and industrial waste, and the prime contaminants are nitrates and phosphates. Right? So, these basically act as plant nutrients. Right, so basically they overstimulate the growth of algae, and there is a lot of robbing of the water of dissolved oxygen, because of which the aquatic life completely disappears. At the same time, the pollutants which are flowing into the lake may poison whole population of fish whose decomposing remains further deplete the water's dissolved oxygen content, and in such fashion the lake literally chokes to death. So, right, there are various reasons again, guys, because of which we are causing great harm to our water bodies. Now, guys, basically, apart from all of these reasons, there are heated, which are known as thermal wastewaters, which comes out of the electricity generating units, which are thermal power plants. Thermal power plants. They are also causing, major pollution, so they are also important category of pollutants. So basically, the thermal wastewater completely eliminates or reduces the number of organisms which are sensitive to high temperature, and they enhance the growth of plants and fishes in extreme cold areas, but only after causing damage to the indigenous flora and fauna. So guys, there are so many different types of effluents or pollutants which are present in water, and we have to be very much aware of what we are doing to our water bodies. So guys, I hope you would have understood the entire concept of the water pollution and how we can actually prevent it. So please do like the video and share it with all your friends. And guys, if you're new to the channel, please do subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon. And do give your feedback or do ask your doubts. You can ask your doubts in the comment of the video, or you can send your doubts on WhatsApp. Thanks for watching this video, guys. See you in the next one. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.